after a 3 or 4 month hiatus, but I Digress is back, baby!
A happy moment.
My apologies for this video being a little late to the party, but coordinating schedules in order to get it made the last couple of weeks has been a pain in the neck. But I did review this movie more immediately for Giga Geek magazine in print and on the Strangers and Aliens podcast, which you can find links to both in this video description. Regardless, enjoy the video!
Cybersaur, I forgot how cool you were. So glad I picked this book up over at Appleseed Comic Con. Hello? Oh, Marshall Pentecost. Sir, nice to hear from you. What? A kaiju just came ashore from Lake Michigan and is attacking Gary, Indiana? So what? This is Gary we're talking about here. He can eat it. Okay. I'm sorry. All right, I understand. Yes. Canceling the apocalypse and all that good stuff. Alright, I'll get right on it.
Ha ha! Iotron, activate!
You're not reviewing the sequel to Pacific Rim, right?
I'm not?
No, this is for the new Godzilla movie.
Oh.
Turn around, it's fair play. Oh, and by the way, Sergio called. He wanted to do the review with you.
Okay. But I wanted a giant robot!
You got the touch! You got the power! Yeah!
Hello, I am Nathan Marchand, and this is a review of the new Godzilla. With me today is my special guest, Sergio, who is a horror movie fan, and since I am a huge fan of Godzilla, of the franchise, I figured this would be the perfect marriage between our interests, and we've been talking about having Sergio on the show for a really long time, so I thought this was the perfect opportunity. We're also coming to you live, I guess you could say, from Sergio's room. That's why the setting is a little bit different than normal.
I mean, I don't want to spoil anything.
Yeah, so we're trying to keep this spoiler free. I had originally wanted to talk about some spoilers in the film, but Sergio insisted that we keep it spoiler free. So, Sergio, what did you think of the movie?
It was pure awesomeness. It was really good. I wasn't really expecting to go in and seeing a bad film. I mean, it's Godzilla. It's a reboot of Godzilla, but it's fresh. It's fresh. Mm-hmm. It comes at you strong. The plot was very good. The character design was awesome.
The creature design?
The creature design, yeah.
And we got illustration of that right here. You went and bought this action figure the same weekend the movie came out. I don't know if you could. Oh, well, you can see that or not. But all of the staples you expect with Godzilla are here. The long tail, the spines on the back, the shape of his snout. You know, all of those trademarks are there, and because of the advances in special effects, since they're not using a man in a suit, they are using CGI, they're able to take that design and actually make it a little bit more realistic. Godzilla doesn't quite walk flat-footed like a man in a suit would. He does have a bit more of a dinosaur gait to his walk. I know some people were being sticklers about the character and the plot about that, because there are very outspoken critics for this movie. I have rarely seen so much rage on IMDb before. You know, people going on there, not just giving negative reviews, but insulting anybody who actually liked this movie and accusing them of being bribed to leave good reviews. I mean, it was absolutely ridiculous.
That sounds really ridiculous.
Yeah. I mean, if you want to disagree, disagree. But don't make everyone else look like an idiot because they happen to disagree with you. But this movie, if you've been a fan of the franchise like I have, it does use a lot of I hesitate to say this, but, you know, the stock characters you expect in that. Military personnel, scientists, because they show up all the time in the old Godzilla movies, because, generally speaking, those are the people you want to talk to when a, you know, 400-foot dinosaur suddenly shows up and terrorizes the city.
Definitely necessary when something like that happens. Overall, there was no annoying characters in this film, which I appreciated. The thing is that it decided to have, you know, Godzilla more of a subplot instead of the main plot, which makes sense, you know? So they'll have the main plot cut off, Godzilla, awesome! Godzilla's about to do something, cut off, go back to main plot, and then main plot, cut back to Godzilla, and oh, it's about to go down, cut, go back to main plot. But, you know, overall, it does pay.
The thing that's great about this is that there's actually some big-name talent in this. You have Bryan Cranston, people.
Fresh out of Breaking Bad, does an awesome job.
Oh my gosh, easily the best actor in this movie. Yeah. And Ken Watanabe was pretty awesome in this too. He was Dr. Sarazawa, which for fans like me, that's a recognizable name. That's a character from the original movie.
I haven't seen him. I mean, I want to say I've seen him before, but I don't remember.
Ken Watanabe, he had a small part in Batman Begins, and he was in Inception.
There you go. That's
and have you seen Last Samurai?
No, I haven't.
Oh, okay. That was his big break, was being in Last Samurai. It's a good movie, by the way. So
what can you tell me about this new director?
Garth Edwards. Garth Edwards is an interesting fellow. This is actually only his second movie, but his first movie was an indie film called Monsters, which... Have you seen Monsters?
I haven't seen it.
Yeah, I think you should watch Monsters. You'll see where a lot of the things that you saw in Godzilla, you'll see in Monsters. Particularly the pacing of the movie, which is something that's been probably the most polarizing thing about Godzilla. You know, we'll get to that, is the pacing of the film. But Monsters is even less about the creatures, and it's more about these two characters who are going on a journey together. They're trying to get from Mexico back to the United States, but in order to do that, they have to pass through the Mexican wilderness, which has just been quarantined because at certain seasons of the year, it gets quarantined because there are giant creatures roaming in the wilderness.
That sounds pretty interesting.
Yeah. Well, the thing about that one is that Garth Edwards wrote and directed it in a way that, as you put it, the Spielberg movie is always just over the hill, so the characters would miss it just barely most of the time. You know, and that's definitely true in this, and that's the weird thing when I was watching the movie. I had to reorient myself, because I went into it thinking it would be a bit more like an old school Godzilla movie, or maybe even like Pacific Rim, but it's actually more like Monsters, and I remember, oh wait, that's how Garth Edwards works. And I think that's very in keeping with the original film, the original Japanese film, which I would like to show you sometime, because it's an amazing movie. Yeah, where it's more about the characters. It's not just a giant lizard rampaging through a city. If you want that, watch Beast from 20,000 Fathoms, you know. It's more than that. It's how Godzilla affects the characters, affects all of Japan, you know. He was this atomic allegory, you know. The Japanese are still the only country in history to have a nuclear bomb dropped on them. So the original film was made as a reflection of that, a meditation upon that. And there are still shades of that sort of commentary in this film as well.
Yeah, they do bring up Hiroshima.
They bring up Hiroshima, but you know, those opening scenes in the nuclear power plant and the disaster that follows that, it's a lot like Fukushima, the the nuclear accident happened in Japan just a few years ago. Pacific Rim was an action movie.
Yeah.
Really, at its heart, it was an action movie. I mean, it had one or two scenes that were kind of horror-esque, but it really was an action movie, and this is not an action movie. They're the same genre, but they're two very different, pardon the pun, two very different beasts.
Yeah.
And, I mean, it's almost like comparing Avengers and The Dark Knight Rises, you know, because those came out during the same summer. They're both superhero movies, but they're both also very different. You know, Avengers is colorful, and it's fun, it's over the top, and that's how Pacific Rim is. But then you have The Dark Knight Rises, and The Dark Knight Rises is gritty, and it's serious, it's dark, and the same comparison can be made to this new Godzilla movie.
I mean, I'm going to say something right now, and I don't think it's going to spoil anything for you guys, but there's definitely going to be a sequel.
No, I've already announced a sequel.
There's definitely going to be a sequel, and hopefully when they decide to make these sequels that we get more Godzilla action. I mean, I want to see stuff like Pacific Rim, where it's hand on hand, just bashing and just going all out. You know?
Yeah.
I really hope they bring some of the classic monsters from Godzilla. If you can name a few.
Rodan, Mothra.
I mean, that'd be awesome.
Yeah. But I don't think that the pacing necessarily hurts the movie. It's more like it's more like old school horror movies. You know, it's things like Jaws or Alien,
yeah.
Where you don't see the creatures themselves for a while, but you see what they do.
Yeah, I agree.
Or you see the aftermath of what they do, and then about halfway through the movie, then you see the creatures, and even then, they're still used strategically so that they maintain a sense of mystique and terror along the way.
You don't see Godzilla through maybe like half the movie, and when you see him, you know it's Godzilla.
Oh, yeah. It's crazy. And that's actually one of the things I like about the style of the movie is that almost every shot in the movie is from ground level. So you're always, you get this impression that you're always looking up. Like when Godzilla is first unveiled, you know, a full body shot, the camera starts at ground level, you see his feet, his stubby little feet, which is about the only thing about the design I don't like, and it pans up. And then you see his face, you know?
And then he just roars right at you.
Yeah, and I'll say, the CGI in this is used sparingly, but because it's used sparingly, they could throw a lot more effort and money at it to make the shots that are in it good. And it still looks like the old man in a suit sort of a design, as you can see right here, unlike the old 1998 movie that made him look like a giant iguana. Really only Godzilla in name only.
We'll leave that for some other time.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. I could rip into that for a good long time. But, so I was happy to see that. And I do like the homespun artistry and charm of those big rubber suits in the old Japanese movies. But I gotta tell you, Godzilla's never looked more alive before than he did in this movie.
I mean, we're talking, you definitely need to go see this in theaters.
Oh, yeah.
Do yourself a favor and don't wait till it comes out on DVD or Blu-ray. Go see it.
Oh, yeah. And if you have a chance to see it in IMAX, I recommend you do that too, because there aren't too many movies that I go out of my way to see in IMAX, and this was one of them. Because everything is just huge and spectacular. And when I saw it, I actually had to sit fairly close to the front, so I had to look up a little, which I thought was appropriate for a movie like this. But you saw it in a regular theater, and it was still really good for you.
I've seen it twice in regular theater here in town, and it's still awesome. It's pretty epic.
Oh, yeah.
Don't wait till it comes out. I'm just going to throw that out again.
Oh,
just
yeah.
Go see it. Take your girlfriend, your wife, your friends, your neighbor. Just go see it.
So it's a date movie, huh? Who would have thought Godzilla was a date movie?
It could be. I don't see why not.
So, overall, with a simple but compelling story, some excellent acting, particularly from Ken Watanabe and Bryan Cranston, great creature design, and overall great respect for the source material, I give Godzilla an A-.
I'm going to go and give it a 9. It's a good movie. Check it out. That's all I got to say. I mean, you're going to have to judge it yourself. But overall, it's a good film. So, go see it.
All right. Well, thank you very much, Sergio, for being on the show. I'd love to have you on again. So, this is Nate and Sergio signing off. This is Nate and Sergio signing off.
That was easy.
Yeah, it probably looks awful though.